hello and good day to all. As part of the National COVID-19 Vaccination Deployment Plan, the Vaccine Information Management System, or the VIMS, was developed to streamline the vaccination process and to rise to the challenge of achieving herd immunization. Staying on top of the VIMS is the DICT as Chair of the Data Resiliency for Ease of Access and Management, or the DREAM Team. Provided for by the IATF Resolution Number 85, issued on November 26 of 2020, the DREAM Team is tasked with the design, development, deployment, monitoring, and evaluation of the Philippine COVID-19 Vaccination Information System. The VIMS covers the entire immunization process, from registration to the actual inoculation, and it even offers the monitoring facility to adverse events following immunization. However, data and insights are still continuously being harnessed to scale up and further improve the system. In other words, the VIMS provides holistic support to the immunization program by utilizing digitalization from pre-implementation up to post-implementation of its inoculation cycle. Through its modular design, the VIMS is adaptable to the varying processes and capacities of LGUs and bakuna centers. As of the moment, the VIMS is composed of two main subsystems, which are the VIMS IR, or the Immunization Registry, and the DIVAS, or the DICT Vaccine Administration System. The VIMS Immunization Registry is designed to gather information for demand planning, allocation, and distribution of the vaccines in the pre-implementation phase of the immunization program. Meanwhile, the DIVAS simultaneously facilitates and gathers valuable information during actual vaccination on the ground, making processes more efficient. Such is the power of the digital transformation. As proven by the San Juan pilot launch conducted on April 16, their turnaround time was cut into half after employing the DIVAS in their inoculation process. Prior to its implementation, the turnaround time was 20 minutes, which was cut down to 10 minutes after the implementing DIVAS wave application. However, aside from the shortening of the inoculation process, another positive response came from the San Juan frontline officers who are tasked with the submission of end-of-day reporting to their heads. The DIVAS offers dashboard with a variety of data categorization, which saves our frontliners valuable time in collating necessary reports. This is time that can be spent for much needed respite of our dear frontliners. Technologies like the Vaccine Information Management System are the sick brains between public and public servants in this time of social distancing. It is technology that exposes, rather than obscures, the warm human link behind Hyperlink, which historically is what we really need to overcome adversities. Our country, the Philippines, lies on a unique tectonic settings ideal for volcanic eruptions and earthquakes. We sit at the boundaries of two tectonic plates, the Philippine Sea plate and the Eurasian plate. There are more or less 20 active volcanoes, or those which erupted within the last 600 years in the country. The rising of lava and magma beneath these active volcanoes can induce volcanic earthquakes. The tectonic earthquakes could also happen because of such movement along faults and boundaries. Our country's location is susceptible to volcanic earthquakes activities. Aside from these two, we also experience typhoons, floodings, landslide, and other natural disasters that endangers the lives of citizens. But natural disasters are not the only dangers we experience. There are also what we call man-made disasters. There are fire, transport accidents, industrial accidents, and other man-made disasters that happen in any part of the country. During these disasters, one of the things that is affected is the commercial communication services. The communications lines go down and the transmission of information from the disaster-stricken area to other places is cut down. Thus, it affects the quality of timeliness of response that can be given to the area. As a response to this problem, the Department of Information and Communications Technology built an emergency communication systems that will improve the government's capacity for disaster response. The Government Emergency Communication Systems Mobile Operation Vehicle for Emergency, or GICSMOVE, is a rapid deployment emergency communication system that aims to provide ICT-enabled support to the disaster-stricken areas in the country. It serves as the intermediary connection between the National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council, or NREMC, and the Regional DRRM Unit. The Geeks Move has three features: the Move Hub, the Move Dispatch, and the Move Motorbike. The Move Hub is the fundamental to this integrated communication system, as it serves as the heart of the system. It is synchronized with the NREMC Operations Center to enable wired and wireless connectivity for data and voice communication. The decision makers are given authority to access the hub to monitor, decide, and dispatch resources to the affected area. The Move Dispatch, on the other hand, provide extended coverage of connectivity for responders at ground zero. It also sends critical information to the community, such as evacuation locations and announcements. This will also send and validate video and image to data to the hub. The data gathered will be used by the incident commander to make sound and correct critical decisions. Lastly, those areas that are inaccessible by dispatch because of narrow roads and road blockage will be accessed by the Move motorbike. Thus, no areas will be overlooked. With the Geeks Move, the government would be able to formulate good, quick, and timely and effective decisions and disaster responses to the disaster-stricken areas. Hence, decreasing, if not eliminating, casualties and increasing the chance to save more lives and properties. We hope that the Geeks Moves will serve as an inspiration to all of us to make most of the technology in dealing with the different hazards we encounter. We encourage everyone here to create new ICT-enabled innovations and systems that will benefit all the Filipino people. In 2017, we have crafted the National Broadband Plan in an effort to improve the overall quality of the internet in the country. This is a response to the citizens' call for faster and cheaper internet. Recognizing that we can do better, the government came up with a blueprint that will accelerate the deployment of fiber optic cables and wireless technologies. The plan has one great vision: to provide an inclusive, affordable, and trusted broadband internet access for all. The National Broadband Plan encompasses all prerequisites in achieving this goal. The government will set policy, regulatory, and infrastructural intervention to spur competition in the telecommunications and ICT industry. It will ensure availability, affordability, and quality of broadband internet access. The DICT and the whole government continuously implement our National Broadband Program. We have started the laying of fiber optic cables to fill the gaps in our existing network in Luzon. This will later move south to improve network in Visayas and Mindanao. Alongside this, two cable landing stations are being built to strengthen our international connectivity. DICT is also collaborating with other government agencies to encourage the establishment of common towers. This will reduce the cost of providing access to underserved and unserved areas. In order to close the digital divide, satellite overlay will be built in isolated locations such as mountainous, coastal, and small islands where fiber network facilities can be challenging. This will be in place until such time as fiber and broadband connections reaches them. Once all of these are implemented, we hope finally connect our users to a reliable broadband connection. So what's in it for us? By providing better broadband connection, the government may strengthen e-governance and take advantage of a digital platform to improve public service delivery. Businesses will have better chances of entering the global and digital economy. Lastly, citizens will also have access to unlimited opportunities for personal development and be able to connect communities online. We aim to build a nation that has universal access to the internet. We are still a work in progress, but we are a step farther than we once were. Let us continue to build bridges through technology. Again, a pleasant morning to you all.